Hello everyone, welcome to Sustainable Agriculture and High Tech Ag Digital Week, brought to you by the New Ag International Group. My name is Naomi Brooker and I'll be your host for today's session. First, I'll cover some quick housekeeping items. So if you experience any difficulties with the audio or advancing slides, please refresh your screen with F5. If you are experiencing other issues, hit the question mark button to receive assistance. At any time during the presentation, you can ask questions. You can submit your questions into the Q&A window on the left-hand side of your screen. In 24 hours, you'll receive a link to watch the recording of this session. You can also download a featured white paper in the resource list box on the right-hand side. So let's now begin by introducing our speaker from Van Iperen, Eric van den Berg, Managing Director based in the Netherlands. So thank you for joining us today, Eric. Now I'll hand over to you to begin your presentation.
Okay, good day to everybody, and thank you very much for joining our webinar. My name is Eric, and I'm going to share with you two of our new innovations that we believe can have a serious significant contribution towards more sustainable agriculture. I'm very sorry that you cannot see me, but at least you have good slides to look at, and that is perhaps the most important. So now let's get started. The first slide, and only one slide, about our company, Van Iperen and Van Iperen International. Our group actually was founded in 1921, so exactly 100 years ago, founded as a distributor in the Netherlands. Over the time, it became also a producer of soluble and liquid fertilizers. And in 2010, myself joined Van Iperen, and we founded Van Iperen International. Nowadays, we are active in over 100 different countries. We have people, agronomists, and offices all over the globe, and we are developing a full set of specialty fertilizers and biostimulants. Two of them, we are going to speak about them right now, and that is where this webinar is all about. So let's get to the topic, and of course to the main challenge that already started. It's time for action, as we all know, to reduce the carbon footprint of agriculture, and at the same time also, maybe as important, to safeguard the biodiversity. Of course, all agronomists, all the farmers also should realize that we should be able to feed a growing world population. I remember a study in Wageningen University saying that in the next 40 years, farmers have to produce the same amount of food as in the last 8,000 years. That is what exponential growth of a world population is actually doing. So that means what we need is high-tech agriculture in a sustainable way. We cannot go back to Beatrice Potter's Peter Rabbit type of agriculture, but high-tech intensive agriculture is what the world can feed. And that's exactly where we as Van Iperen feel most comfortable, and we would like to contribute. And we do that under our new motto, Let's Make the Green Switch, where we are eager to change the rules of the game in plant nutrition and to help farmers to cope with all those challenges with innovative, even disruptive solutions. The two projects I would like to speak about today is first Green Switch, and after that, Plant for Plants. About the green switch, perhaps the easiest way to explain to you is with a small animation that I will show you in a minute. It's an animation of less than 2 minutes, but it will explain very well what this is all about. The focus of our green switch, I will come back to that later as well, but it's clear that it is about all these themes that are so important for sustainable agriculture. How to improve the organic matter in the soil, how to get to circularity, reducing carbon footprint, look at nutrient use efficiency, as well as water use efficiency, all the developments that we as Van Ieperen are promoting and are studying are actually around one or several of these themes. But again, the first one I would like to speak about is the green switch. Next to some other solutions that you already developed in the past and that you may know, the IPE technology, the Folius team, algae solutions, Wake Up for the drought tolerance, together with green switch and Plant for Plants. That's actually the topics that concern us and that we are fully committed. I'm sorry with a little bit of a delay, but here comes the green switch introduction slide, fertilizing a green future. And actually, green switch has a unique process because what we are doing is we are turning manure into a sustainable liquid nitrate solution. And that nitrate solution has a zero carbon footprint, which is quite unique. We believe it is the world's first nitrate derived from organically derived raw materials. Again, I will show you now first a video that will explain the whole concept and hopefully.
Not so very long ago, all farms were mixed farms. At that time, the nitrogen cycle of livestock farming and crop farming was balanced. Farmers faced the challenge to feed a growing world population. Mineral fertilizers played a major role in their success. Farmers specialized. Mixed farms disappeared. The nitrogen cycle got disrupted. Today, livestock farming creates manure surplus, and nitrogen emissions harm the environment. At the same time, growers need to reduce their carbon footprint. Agriculture, on the other hand, still needs large amounts of fertilizer. At Van Ieperen International, we have found a sustainable way to restore the balance. We turn biogas installations into high-tech fertilizer factories. This is how it works. In a biogas installation, we strip the ammonium from the liquid fraction of the manure. Then, bacteria turn the ammonium into liquid nitrate fertilizer. So in essence, we turn nitrogen from manure into a crystal clear fertilizer. The green switch production process has a close to zero carbon footprint. This has groundbreaking consequences. Growers of fruit and vegetables can significantly reduce their carbon footprint and at the same time restore the nitrogen cycle by using green switch fertilizers. We're eager to offer a completely sustainable, high-end fertilizer range for greenhouses and open field fertigation. Green switch is not just an idea, it's reality, and it's beginning now.
Okay, that was the little animation. I believe it was quite clear to explain the concept, how the different sectors, the livestock farming as well as the fruit and vegetable grower can contribute to solve part of the sustainability issues. Maybe another slide now with a little bit more details about how it is actually working. So as you could understand, we are starting actually with the manure, but not just with the manure. For the people that are a little bit more knowledgeable about it, we are starting with the liquid digestate that we derive from a manure process. Out of the digestate, we are stripping actually the ammonia nitrogen in the form of NH3, and that ammonium solution we are turning in a bioreactor to a nitrate solution. The nitrate there is connected to a potassium cation, so to become a purified potassium nitrate solution. To purify it, we go through different steps to concentrate it as well as to purify the product, and at the end we have a potassium nitrate solution ready to be used even in the high-tech greenhouses and any other kind of fertigation or fodder application. You can see here also the names of a few companies. Let me explain that a little bit more. The technology that we are speaking about today is actually developed by the American company PureGreen. They are the holder of the technology. Van Ypres, we are the not only doing the marketing of the final products, the nitrate solution, but we're also responsible to outroll the installation of the industrial projects at manure processors to install in different countries the production units and to operate them. The last company mentioned here, Agro Energy Hardenberg, is actually a biogas producer in the Netherlands, where we have today the first commercial plant in the east of the Netherlands. And this manure processor, the biogas producer, is actually the industrial partner, as we call them, in this Green Switch project. And the aim is that in the future, more of such industrial partners in different places in the world, wherever you have manure processing in a concentrated way, can become a partner and produce the green switch for a local production of a nitrate solution for the local farming community. The advantages of the green switch, I believe you could already figure out from the animation as well. Let me quickly repeat that. First of all, the advantage for the greenhouse grower or the fruit and vegetable grower and or the pot plant grower, the ornamental grower, is that he will make his nitrogen fertilization with a close to zero carbon footprint. I may remind you that nowadays synthetic nitrogen fertilizers are all produced with the Haber-Bosch and Oswald technology. This technology to capture and to produce ammonia and to produce nitrate or nitric acid have a very high carbon footprint because they have a huge need of energy. With Green Switch, you avoid all these steps and instead you have a zero carbon footprint. And that, of course, is for the grower a big advantage, because fertilization after heating, when it is about a greenhouse, is one of the biggest consumers, the biggest cause of carbon dioxide. The second advantage is the circular economy. We are taking the nitrogen from the livestock farming, and we apply that, we reutilize that in the greenhouse or in the open field, contributing to the real circular economy thought. Instead of pumping all the time fresh nitrogen from the nitrogen industry into the system, we are recirculating the nitrogen that is already available. A big advantage for the livestock farmer as well as for the manure processor is that we reduce the emission of nitrogen. You may not all be fully aware, but in countries like the Netherlands and in any other place where you have a high density of livestock farming, there is a real problem with nitrogen emission. Nitrogen in the form of ammonium that turns to ammonia is going into the air, and after later on coming back with rainfall, etc., deposit on the land or in a nature reserve, it will cause has an influence on the biodiversity of the flora, and this emission is actually seen in many countries as a big problem. With our concept, we turn ammonium nitrogen into nitrate, which is not volatile, and by using it in a smart and intelligent way in greenhouses, etc., you will have no further emission. So that's a big advantage for the livestock farmer that has an issue here. Last but not least, we will have with the Green Switch certain organic farming certificates. I will come back to that later, but of course for those organic farmers that today have no nitrate options available, it is also a big breakthrough to better manage their crop with a fast available nitrate fertilizer. The carbon footprint argument is actually quite significant, as already mentioned. If you take a 10 hectares tomato grower, then actually he can save about 120,000 kilo of CO2 equivalent per year, which is comparable to taking 50 cars out of the from the road. Circular economy, also already explained, this is a big advantage because we close the nitrogen circle we bring from manure back into agriculture, so we utilize it, reutilize it as a fertilizer, and we believe that this is a big advantage. We don't take it from the air and we don't release it back to the air. Nitrogen emission reduction, this is the big advantage for on the production side, the manure processor that will have a nitrogen emission, this green switch, that is close to zero. Actually, by doing so, he will, and again, with having in mind the consumption of a greenhouse grower of 10 hectares of tomatoes, you have a saving of 80 cows or 850 pigs that you avoid the emission of the nitrogen. So there's a big and important saving, which is actually being seen as very significant as a potential solution for the nitrogen problem that and the nitrogen emission problem that we are nowadays discussing in the Netherlands. More details about that, I'm happy to provide you separately. And again, last but not least, we see that having an organically derived nitrate solution with an organic farming certificate is seen as a kind of a holy grail also for the organic farmers. We will not have that all over the world, especially in the first couple of years. We don't expect it in the European Union because of the legislation in Europe is not yet allowing a fast nitrogen to be certified. However, talking about OMRI in the US or CFDA in California, as well as ACOS and Kiva, we have possibilities in many important other parts of the world. Australia, again, also US, California, Canada, other places, and of course all the farmers that are producing under those certificates for these markets, and that can also be in the Netherlands or in other European countries. The green switch is at first going to be offered in a formulation that is a potassium nitrate formulation. So we have connected the nitrate to potassium. However, our aim is to expand the program pretty rapidly with other nitrate products. The products will be marketed in the Netherlands mostly in bulk, because that is how the greenhouses are being organized. They receive the fertilizers in bulk. To the rest of the world, we mostly consider IBC packaging. The 20-liter can that you see on the picture here is probably more for sampling, but 20-liter and IBC is what will be available. As I mentioned, the factory is started up last month, so it's now fully operational, and we are looking forward to get it all started, also the commercial approach. The way forward, I didn't mention yet, but we were very pleased last week to be awarded the Horticultural HortiContact Innovation Award. That is given to what is seen as the biggest innovation this year for the greenhouse sector in the Netherlands. And we are quite proud about that, because it shows really the big interest this market segment has for a solution like Greenswitch. The expansion of the production in the Netherlands is our first aim. That means we have a lot of menu to capture, so we have a lot of potential to grow in the Netherlands and to expand the production there. Once that is done, we also would like to consider and to start installations of facilities worldwide. We have many countries that already showed interest, and everywhere where there is manure processing and we're able to capture the manure and the nitrogen from there, and there is a local market for fruit and vegetables, greenhouses that have an interest in this product, then we would like to move. And it's clear that doing so, it is not only in a sustainable way, but it is also becoming a local production for local farming. And that's another element that makes Greenswitch, I would say, a beautiful concept. Okay, that is about the Greenswitch, first of all. I understand you have a chance for asking questions only at the end of the presentation. My second part of the presentation is about the Plants for Plants, which is another totally different kind of innovation that you might have already heard about, because it's a project that we are working on for the last more than 5 years. Let me introduce it quickly again, what is the background, and then come to some latest developments and latest results of the trials that we are doing in 2020 and 21. In short, with Plant for Plants, we are developing a new generation of biostimulants meant for conventional agriculture as well as for organic agriculture. Just a little bit of history about the Plants for Plants. What we call the godfather of the project is actually Dr. Adriano Altissimo from Land Lab in Italy. He started with the whole concept of Plants for Plants in his labs already and in his mind already more than 10 years ago, developing the idea and developing the research and the literature research of the whole principle of Plant for Plants. Then since 2016, we as Van Ypres got more officially involved, being the exclusive marketing and development partner. And since then, actually, we are a part of the R&D and part of the preparation. Also in production and rolling the whole program to get to the market towards next year. There were different steps, actually, all also partly guided by the European Union. And the last step that we are actually working on now is the go-to-market project that is under the live project of the EU, which makes it supported by Europe, because Europe believes that this is a significant contribution towards more sustainable agriculture. Of course, there are, when you talk about a new generation of biostimulants, you first ask yourself what is already available in the market of biostimulants. And I think we all know that we have a number of, great products in the market, that we are also learning every day what those products can potentially do to a crop under abiotic stress conditions. We have the seaweeds, we have the amino acids, we have the humic acids, the fulvic acids, etc. Again, those have great potential, but they also have certain limitations. It's a very limited group of products. So you wonder yourself, if those four products or five products have already such potential, what more is available in nature? And that was exactly the thinking of Adriano Altissimo when he started thinking about the Plant for Plants. Also, some of those current biostimulants, they are not really renewable. and they are not always easy to steer, to control from sink to source. And yeah, there is a debate about are they always the same and do they have always the same effect, or how do you select the right biostimulants? Limited fantasy, there are only 4 to 5 basic products available. And like that, there are a few remarks. Also, the claims that those biostimulants do are in general quite generic. They are quite general. They're not very focused on solving specific issues. And that's actually what also that is something that with the Plan for Plans, Adriano tried to really change the rules of the game. So Plan for Plans, what is the concept and what was the way of thinking that it all got started? Actually, what we did and what Adriano did was to start with the challenge of what problem in we would like to attack. Is it drought stress? Is it salt stress? Is it something else? We started with a certain problem. And then we did, mostly from literature study, we looked at what kind of crops, what kind of other species already found a solution or a partial solution for that specific problem. Certain species, as we all know, are able to cope better with a certain stress than other plants, other species. And those species we can learn something from. And in that species, Adriano started to study what kind of metabolites, ingredients, what kind of material actually contributed to make that plant being more resistant, more tolerant to a certain stress factor. And once he identified that source, we tried to not only to isolate it and to extract it to a certain formulation, we also tried to see how can we get out of that plant the maximum of that specific metabolites. How can we grow maybe different varieties that have a higher content of that specific metabolite? Once we have all sorted that out, and once we could formulate that extract to a stable product, we started to look how we could industrially scale up the production and be able to offer such a product that meantime was of course fully tested and shows in lab trials, in greenhouse trials, in chamber growth chamber trials, as well as hundreds of field trials, shows that this specific extracts, these specific formulations had a certain effect, similar effect when applied in a certain way through verification or through foliar in another crop, another commercial crop. So that's why it's Plans for Plants. We start with plants that we can grow, that we can cultivate, to extract certain metabolites that turn out to have a certain very specific advantage when applied also to other commercial plants, and able to really boost that plant in a certain stress condition, or as we saw later, even in what appeared to be quite a comfortable, optimal growth situation. What makes the Plan for Plants by this approach different and perhaps as a new generation from other biostimulants? Well, there are a few things. We grow the plant from the beginning to the end, and we really try scientifically to understand what to extract, what to take out of the plant, what is the effect, and how can it be optimized? It's a very scientific approach. I would like to mention we have 10 years or meantime of scientific research. We are also finalizing our knowledge about the mode of action. That is very important to understand why a biostimulant like this has a certain effect also in another plant. So at the moment we are finalizing the last trials to really figure out also the mode of action. We have proven claims that are well identified. Is it about a certain fortification? Is it about nutrient use efficiency? Is it about drought tolerance, salt stress, etc.? We have identified a number of metabolites with very clear proven claims. Last but not least, they are all natural plant extracts, and actually all the process afterwards, the extraction and the formulation, we make it food grade, so to also have not only a safe product and to have it safe for the consumer and have also a safe for the environment, but also to enable an easy short track in the whole registration process afterwards. At the moment, we have developed more than 10 different extracts that have a potential of a good biostimulant for certain application. Right now, we have 3 products that are close to market, and that with the help of the LIFE project, we are actually bringing to the market. One is focused mostly on the water use efficiency, one is focused on nutrient use efficiency, and the last one is focused on crop fortification efficiency, so giving the crop more strength against the tolerance for diseases and etc. And those 3 products are actually we are undergoing in the LIFE at the moment, and we have in 2020 again after years of scientific trials in 2020 we have now done with the help of LIFE a number of demonstration trials in all the European climate zones. COVID, of course, with all the travel restrictions, have also limited us a little bit, but still we have about 24 trials that we already have performed, and we had very good results. You can see here it's a summary of the trial results, between very good results to no results. It's in general for the water use efficiency and the nutrient use efficiency is the vast majority of the trials where we have seen a very good effect. Again, amazing to see that this is not only when stress conditions really appeared, but also when no stress appeared, or at least apparently no stress appeared, like in a fertile, humid situation in the Netherlands or in Finland. I show you here only the summary of the whole overview. I'm sorry not to to bring some individual trials. There is a bit of lack of time. But if you look at our website under the Plant for Plants section, you can find there already a large number of individual trial reports that you can have a look at. Again, these are the trials done as demonstration together with our distribution partners all over Europe. These are not the scientific trials that we did and we are still doing year after year for the last more than 5 years. But just to show you how also in practice actually the biostimulants are from Plant for Plants are bringing great results. In 21, we are actually continuing the trial plan, and we have a much larger number of demonstration trials. We are now talking about 120 trials that have been set up and are already set up and currently under execution. This represents about 650 hectares in 20 different countries, again, all the different climate zones and in many different crops. So soon you will have the results of that as well. Also with Plant for Plants, of course, we are looking for the way forward. We are currently setting up the production facility. As I mentioned, the industrial scale up is of course a must. How to get to a stable production and repeatable production, that is something that is we put a lot of work in the last couple of years. And we are right now having the first production facility nearly on stream. And we are expecting to be able to introduce the Plant for Plants, the first two or three prototypes to introduce at the end of 21, so the end of this year. We are still setting up and discussing with our distribution partners, also open to discuss and currently discussing with a few B2B marketing partners. And yeah, we expect to launch the plan for plans in a commercial way in end of 21, season 22. And it's clear that we are looking forward to do so. Biostimulants, the future of biostimulants, I think is very clear. They have a big place in agriculture. And the good thing is that we are moving away from only using them in a pure stress situation or having an effect in stress situation, but also in what appears to be an optimal situation for the crop, you can still have a good performance and a great application. So let us convince you with the 21 trial results later this year, and I hope to be able to see you in the market and to join forces to introduce Plan for Plans in 22. Thank you very much. I believe this is this ends the presentation, and I believe we are just on time still to answer a few questions. So please feel free. I'm available, and I would like to thank you very much for your attention for the last 40 minutes to the two new products. Thank you very much.
Okay. Well, thank you, Eric, for that excellent presentation, and also congratulations with the Horti Contact Innovation Award that you mentioned. So we have received a few questions already, but we'll give the rest of you some time just to enter in your questions in the Q&A box to the left of the slides. I'd also just like to take this opportunity to thank Van Iperen and Planet for sponsoring this digital week. And also just a reminder to check out the resources list on the right of your screen. So now we'll go back to Eric for some of the questions. So one question that we have, which would be great for your reply, is green fertilizers are being developed by many players in the market. Why is Green Switch special?
Okay, thank you very much for that question. Why is the Green Switch special? Well, there are many special products and great innovations going on in agriculture, but we believe that the Green Switch is special because it is the world's first organically derived nitrate fertilizer. We all believe that we have to go to a more sustainable agriculture, but I think any agronomist will also confirm that can only be with the availability of nitrate fertilizers, because it is with nitrate and nitrogen that a high-tech farmer, is it in a greenhouse but also in open fields, is able to steer, to manage, and to boost his crop. So if we want to combine sustainable agriculture with high-tech, high-output, intensive type of farming, then we need this kind of product. And I'm very glad that with Green Switch we have found the solution to do so. So I believe it is this fact, the first nitrate fertilizer that meets the criteria of a zero carbon footprint, that is the game changer that we are offering.
Okay, thank you for that answer. There's also a question that's been posted in. Is the Green Switch fertilizer water soluble?
Can you please repeat?
Yep. Is the Green Switch fertilizer water soluble?
Yes, as a matter of fact, it is produced as a liquid. So it is a liquid, clear, crystal clear, looks like water liquid fertilizer. So it is indeed therefore fully can be utilized in any fertigation system or any foliar application, so as a soluble product.
Okay, thank you. Are you focusing on the organic farming with these innovations or also on the regular segments?
Well, as I mentioned, the main focus of our company is on the conventional farming, because we believe the big challenge of agriculture is to make conventional farming more sustainable. That will be the big through. However, also organic farmers have shown a big interest in the green switch, because for them, having a nitrate fertilizer available in their own cropping system is a big advantage. It will give them the ability and the same means, the same tools like a conventional farmer has to boost his crop. As I mentioned in my presentation, we are currently certifying the products under a number of certification bodies, and the ones that are most advanced or already obtained is like OMRI and CFDA, but also the certification for countries like Australia, Japan, number of other countries will be possible. In Europe, it will take a little bit longer because the European legislation doesn't allow what they call fast nitrogen to be applied in an organic by an organic farmer. And although we believe that this is something that probably will change, and we are working on that to change that, but it will take a couple of two or perhaps 2 years more to get that certificate.
Thank you for that answer. There was another question. So green switch, linked to green switch, it was mentioned it can be used for organic farming in certain countries outside of the EU. Are there any countries or regions in particular that this technology is already present in, or where will you be focusing on?
That is correct. So indeed, there are a few countries where we have the first breakthrough. That is especially in the United States, where with the OMRI and the CFDA, there is a big interest to utilize the green switch. Thinking about the big market in California, for instance, where there's a lot of organic farming. But also other regions in the world. I'm talking about Japan, I'm talking about Australia. We're talking about a lot of also production locations in countries that are producing for other markets, like for the United States market. They also sometimes, the growers work according OMRI or according one of the existing certificates. So there is a broad number of countries where we see a lot of interest. United States, if you ask me what country is on top, then today I would put the United States as the country that is most advanced in their switch to the green switch.
Okay. Thank you for that. I'll just remind people now, we're just looking up the time, so it's a call for any final questions. We do have one more, but if anybody else wants to ask a question, please do post it through now. So is P4P only useful in stress situations or under what conditions?
So with the Plant for Plants, we aim to develop different kinds of products, different kinds of new biostimulants. The drought tolerance is one of the prototypes is especially focused indeed on drought tolerance and salt stress situations. However, even that prototype, we are learning that in practice it is doing much more than that. Sometimes we make the comparison with humans. I mean, the more luxury we have, the easier we are feeling also stress. And maybe that's also true with plants, that plants that seems to be in a very comfortable, optimal growing condition can still have a lot of stress situations. And maybe that explains why we see that the plant for plants products, they have much more to offer to the farmer than only a kind of insurance against the drought tolerance or against other kind of abiotic stress situation. It's something that probably in the coming years we are going to learn much more about it and also to understand much more about it. But the field trials and the demonstration trials that we are going through are clearly learning us that it is not only drought tolerance that you are making an insurance against. It is more than that. But indeed, drought tolerance, nutrient use efficiency, these are specific situations or specific aims to be chosen in order to choose one of the different prototypes that we're now going to launch commercially at the end of this year.
Okay, thank you for that, Eric, and thank you also for a really great session and the support also from Van Iperen hosting this session today. Just to let everybody know, this session was recorded and you will receive notification in 24 hours when you can view the on-demand recording. And if before you do log off, if you are able just to take a moment to complete the feedback form so we can always continue to improve the Digital Week experience. So on behalf of New Ag International, we'll just wish you a great day. Thank you, everybody. Bye-bye.
Thank you.